The MLB draft is possibly the toughest draft to nail in all of sports because there's so many rounds, the players are so young, and even the best players spend a ton of time in the minor leagues. But what if every MLB team drafted perfectly? What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Touchdowns to Home Runs. My name is Bernie, and today we are going to be doing a 2010 MLB redraft. With the first pick in the 2010 MLB draft, the Washington Nationals select Christian Yelich from Westlake High School. Originally with this pick, the Nationals selected Bryce Harper, but Yelich's recent surge moves him from the 23 spot to the number 1. The 28-year-old has played 7 seasons in the MLB, but began his surge in 2016. In the past 2 seasons, Yelich has been a 2-time Silver Slugger, a 2-time All-Star, and has first and second place finishes in the MVP votings. The 2019 season were career highs for Yelich in average OBP, slugging, and OPS. With the second pick in the 2010 MLB draft, the Pittsburgh Pirates select Jacob deGrom from Stetson University. Originally selected by the Pirates with this pick was Jameson Taillon, but back-to-back Cy Youngs have moved deGrom from the 272nd pick to the number 2 pick. In deGrom's 6 seasons in the MLB, each year he has either increased or come close to increasing his Ks to walks ratio. In his young career, deGrom is already a Rookie of the Year, 3-time All-Star, 2-time Cy Young, and has finished in the top 10 of MVP votings 2 times. With the third pick in the 2010 MLB Draft, the Baltimore Orioles select Chris Sale from Florida Gulf Coast University. With this pick, the Orioles originally selected Manny Machado, but Chris Sale has dominated the past 8 years in the AL and moves from the 13th spot to the number 3 spot. Between the 7 seasons from 2012 to 2018, Chris Sale was an All-Star for 7 straight years, a top 6 Cy Young finisher for 7 straight years, and got MVP votes in 4 of the 7 seasons. Chris Sale has a weird arm slot, but it's allowed him to become a dominant strikeout pitcher, allowing minimal home runs. Seasons above 20 home runs. With the 5th pick in the 2010 MLB Draft, the Cleveland Indians select Manny Machado from Brito Miami Private School. Originally selected with this pick, the Angels chose to select Drew Pomeranz. And although Machado falls down from the number 3 selection, he remains at the number 5 pick because of his pop and insane defense. In 8 seasons, Machado has hit over 30 home runs in 5 of them, allowing him to be a 4-time All-Star and 2-time Gold Glove. Not only has Machado shown insane home run power, but he also has very good gap power, with 5 of his 8 seasons with over 30 doubles, including an insane 50 double season. With the 6th pick in the 2010 MLB Draft, the Arizona Diamondbacks select Noah Syndergaard from Legacy High School. Originally selected with the 6th overall pick was Barrett Liu by the Diamondbacks, but what Noah Syndergaard has shown in his limited time on the field has allowed him to move from number 38 to number 6. Noah Syndergaard's entire career has been injury bugged, but he has been good in his limited time, posting a 3.31 ERA, but the injuries are why he can't be higher on this draft list. With just under a 10 Ks per 9, Noah Syndergaard goes into each season with very high expectations, and he could be propelled into the top of the MLB pitcher rankings if he could string together a few healthy seasons. With the 7th pick in the 2010 MLB Draft, the New York Mets select Whit Merrifield from the University of South Carolina. Originally selected with this pick was Matt Harvey, although his career got cut short by injuries, which allows Whit Merrifield to move from number 269 to number 7. Whit Merrifield has only played 4 seasons in the MLB, but his average OBP and insane speed has made him a household name. Merrifield couldn't be drafted any higher because of his lack of experience, but he could definitely be a great piece for the New York Mets. If you made it to this point in the video, thank you. And if you want me to do this with a different year, make sure you leave a thumbs up and let me know in the comment section below. As always, guys, thank you so much for watching. See you next time.